Hello students, hope you all are doing good. Now we are going to start with our new lesson.
You have already studied about internet in your previous class. Now we are going to study some more uses of internet. Our topic is more on the internet. Blogs. A blog or a web blog is a website on which articles are posted regularly. The posts appear in reverse order, with the most recent post at the top of main page. Readers can browse these categories through the blog to read old entries. Blog entries can have text, images, links, audio, video, etc. Authoring a blog, maintaining a blog, or adding an article to an existing blog is called blogging. Web feeds. A web feed or news feed is a facility that informs you when a website you are interested in has new content. News feed highlights information that includes profile changes, upcoming events, etc. Podcast. A podcast is an audio or video file made available for download on the internet, usually as a series. The term podcast is a combination of terms iPod and broadcast. Cloud computing using Google Drive. Google Drive is an online file storage service created by Google. You can keep photos, documents, presentations, videos, etc. in Google Drive. You can view these files from anywhere using your smartphone, computer, or tablet. You can also share these files and folders by inviting others to view, download, or collaborate on these files. Suppose if you have created a document in Word and want to save it in Google Drive, you have to follow these steps. Select Save As option from the File tab. Sign in and save the file in OneDrive. You can also drag the file into Google Drive. To do this, follow the steps. Open a browser, say Google Chrome. Second point is open drive.google.com. Third point is open or create a folder. Fourth point is to upload files or folders, click and drag them into Google Drive folder. You can also share these files by selecting the file and clicking share button. Enter the email address of the person with whom you want to share this file and click the send button. To download a file from Google Drive, first select the file. Right click and select download from the context menu that appears. Our next topic is e-commerce. Commerce refers to exchange of goods and services, usually for money. There are three parties to any such exchange: buyers, sellers, and producers. Buyers are the people with money who want to purchase goods and services. Sellers are the people who offer goods and services to buyers. There are two types of sellers. They are retailers and wholesalers. Producers are the people who create the products and services. We can also say that commerce refers to buying and selling of products. Thus, e-commerce is simply an extension of this concept. Electronic commerce or e-commerce means transactions conducted electronically or through the internet. It is a way of enabling or doing business over the internet. In recent years, e-commerce has grown exponentially in India. Advantages of e-commerce. It is available 24/7. That means the service is available 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. It offers better service to customers. Customers can select the product easily and have greater number of choices from
different providers.
Our next topic is online shopping. Online shopping or e-shopping is a form of electronic commerce which allows consumers to directly buy products or services from a seller over the internet using a web browser. For example, consumers can buy items like books, toys, cosmetics, household items, hardware, etc. from online stores. Examples of online shopping sites are Amazon, eBay, Flipkart, etc. Benefits of e-shopping. It saves travel time. It can provide a better deal on a product. Limitations of e-shopping. Customers cannot touch and feel the product. An internet connection is must. Also, a decent level of knowledge about how to use computer and internet is indispensable, which means absolutely necessary. One more drawback of e-shopping is many people are still concerned about data security and possibility of fraud. They hesitate to enter sensitive information such as credit card numbers on websites. They fear that third parties could misuse the information. Companies are working hard to resolve these issues. Coming to next topic, that is e-ticketing. The internet has become an easy way to complete many of our tasks from the comfort of our homes or offices, thereby saving time and effort. E-ticketing or electronic ticketing allows you to reserve your seats in a bus, train or airplane, book hotel rooms, cinema tickets, and even make a doctor's appointment at the tap of a fingertip. The user may have to simply carry a printout of the ticket and show the same with their personal photo identification proof to avail the service. The Indian Railways allows you to carry your e-ticket in the form of an SMS so that you don't really require the printout. Examples of e-reservation sites are www.yatra.com, www.makemytrip.com, etc. Smartphones provide an easy way to purchase tickets of an airline, railway, or even a movie. Customers can order, pay for, and get their tickets using smartphones. This is called mobile ticketing. This reduces the production and distribution cost as well as the paperwork time. Tickets are usually delivered through a text message.